Hello, and welcome to my YouTube channel. LibreOffice is an exceptional open-source office suite, and in this video, we'll explore some valuable tips and tricks to help you use it more effectively. Whether you're writing documents, creating spreadsheets, or making presentations, these tips will enhance your LibreOffice experience. Some may be familiar, while others could be new surprises. Let's dive in. Extract images from a document. If you have a document with multiple images, save time by extracting them all at once. To extract all the images from a document quickly, save the document as HTML. All you have to do is to click on the file, Save as option, and then save the document as HTML, preferably in a new folder. It will give you a warning, but you can ignore it. Once you save the Word document as HTML, you'll see that all the images have been extracted in the folder where you saved the HTML document. Save files as editable PDFs. If you have a Word document, you can save it as PDF in one click. No external tool required for it. In fact, if you have to share the document with someone else who won't edit it, use the PDF format. The main reason here is that document format gets messed up between LibreOffice and Microsoft Office. Of course, you should also save a copy in the regular document format for future editing. And this is where you can save some time by opting for the hybrid PDF. A hybrid PDF embeds the ODF file in the PDF. It will look like a normal PDF, but you can open it in LibreOffice Writer and edit it like normal ODF document. To enable this option, go to File menu, Export as PDF. Then check the option to embed ODF file. The size of the hybrid PDF will be more than that of the normal PDF file. However, you don't need to save files separately in ODF and PDF formats. You have one single file and that can be easily editable. Edit PDF files. Yes, you can totally do that even if it is not the hybrid PDF you saw in the previous section. The PDF editing works quite good if the PDF was generated from a text file. You can use LibreOffice Draw tool for this task. It comes bundled with LibreOffice Suite. Just open the PDF file in Draw, and you'll see the option to edit the text. Find and use extensions. An extension is basically a tiny piece of code that you can install in LibreOffice to get additional features. Extensions are often the overlooked part of LibreOffice. Perhaps because people are just not aware that such a thing even exists. In LibreOffice, go to Tools, Extensions. You can go to LibreOffice website and browse through the available extensions. You can download the extension in OXD file format. Click on Add and browse to the downloaded extension file. It will be added and enabled immediately. However, to see the changes in effect, you'll have to restart LibreOffice. Password protect a document. Password protecting a document in LibreOffice is literally a child's play. All you have to do is to use the Save as option while saving the document. And when you are doing that, just check the option of Save with password. It will ask you to enter a password and confirm it. Now, when you try to open this file, it will ask you to enter the password. Create read-only documents. If you don't want others to edit the document, you can create the document in read-only format. Additionally, you can password protect it so that anyone can read it but not edit it without the password. You can also create a read-only document without a password. Select Save As, and then check Save with Password option. Click on the options to show more options. The first password field, under File Encryption Password, is to lock the file from opening altogether. The second password field, under File Sharing Password, is to lock the file from editing. You can choose to not set any passwords at this step. This way your document will show the read-only notification. To edit a read-only document, you either press Shift-Ctrl-M or click on Edit, Edit Mode. Make LibreOffice remember your last cursor position. By default, LibreOffice Writer opens at the beginning of every document. It's not a big deal unless you are working with long documents where it helps to know where you were editing the last time. With a simple trick, you can make LibreOffice remember the last cursor position in a document. In the menu, go to Tools Options. From the left pane, select User Data. In here, add your first name and last name. It could be anything. You don't have to match it with your account name. Once done, save and exit. That's it. Now when you open a document in Open Document Format, you'll see that it opens at the last editing point instead of the beginning of the document. Convert existing text into table. Most people add table first and then enter the data. But you can do the opposite too. First, enter the data that you want to convert to a table. The separator can be anything, like tab space, semicolon, etc. Once ready, select the whole text. Go to the table menu on the top, and then go to Convert and choose Text to Table. From the dialog box, select the required separator and press OK. That's it. The text you have entered will be a neat table now. Embed fonts in documents. Say you have created a document using a special type of font. If you want another person to view that file, exactly like you do, then that person should have the font you used installed in their system. It's not convenient. So, LibreOffice can embed the font along with the document, so that anybody who has the document will see it exactly like you intend. First, on the document, click on File, Properties. Now, go to the Fonts tab. Here, you can embed either all the fonts available in LibreOffice, or just embed the fonts that are used in that particular document. If you want to select all the fonts to embed, check on the Embed Fonts in the Document option. Or if you want to embed only the used fonts, select both options. Check accessibility. Accessibility in documents is very crucial. A screen reader-friendly document is essential for the visually impaired people. In LibreOffice, you can check if your document does not have accessibility issues. In a document, go to Tools Accessibility Check. This will open a dialog with all the accessibility issues on your document and a button to go to that particular issue. Change the icon set. Don't like the default looks of LibreOffice? You can change the various icons you see in the menu and other places in LibreOffice. First, select Tools Options. From the new dialog, go to View tab and then change the icons as needed. Automatic scroll. If you are working on long documents and want to skim through it, no need to scroll continuously. Use auto scroll instead. By default, middle click in LibreOffice is paste clipboard. You can change it and use it for continuous auto scrolling. Go to Tools Options View. From there, under mouse section, set middle button behavior to automatic scrolling. Now, if you middle click on a document, a two-sided arrow appears and scrolls in the direction of your choice. Customize the context menu toolbar. Configure the appearance of the toolbar and other sections for minimal clutter. Change user interface. Click on View User Interface. Set the required user interface, like tab, sidebar, etc. Either apply it to the current LibreOffice application like Writer, or apply to all apps at once. Change items in context menu. Select Tools, Customize. On the new dialog, go to Context Menus. Here, use the two arrow button to move items between available commands and assigned commands. Learn to use the right sidebar. The right sidebar in LibreOffice has several tools minimized, like the page settings, styles, format, etc. You can access these tools by clicking on it. After using, hide it by clicking on it again. Add code blocks with syntax highlight. If you are working on technical documents that has code snippets, this trick will be good for you. Though, this is not an inbuilt feature. You need to install Code Highlighter 2 extension to make this work. Install and enable the extension. Restart LibreOffice. Now, write some code and select it. Click on Format, Code Highlighter 2, Highlight Code. On the next dialog box, select the language, then also select the style. Use the preview button to get the look. Once selected, click OK to apply. These are just a few of the many tips and tricks that LibreOffice offers. We hope you found this video helpful in improving your LibreOffice experience. Do you have any favorite LibreOffice tips? Feel free to share them in the comments section below. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more useful tips and tutorials.